Okay, let's jump over to the file browser. So we're here in our glue module directory. And the goal for this next step is to add a page programmatically through our module. And the first thing you're going to think as we start to go through this process is, oh my gosh, what are all these directories for? Because we're going to need to create this nested system of files in order for this to work properly. If you compare this with the Drupal 7 way of doing things, where we don't need any subdirectories, we can just throw everything in our base module directory, it seems like we're overcomplicating things. And we'll talk about this more in detail soon, but just keep in mind that there's a reason for these subdirectories and there will be a payoff. Okay, so the first folder that we need to create is called lib, L-I-B. Lib is short for library, and it's generally where you'll put all of your code, minus what's in your .module file. Your CSS files and your JavaScript files will tend to go outside of the lib directory. And then within this lib folder, I just opened it up, we're going to create a new folder called Drupal. Shortly, we're going to talk about something called PSR0, and this is the first step, along with the next folder that we're going to create, in making our module PSR0 compatible. Don't worry if that sounds weird or obscure for now, we'll totally explain it shortly. Within this folder, we're going to create a new folder that is the name of our module, which is glue. And this is probably the point where you're starting to think, oh man, what's up with all of these directories, especially ones that have the same name as the module? Well, again, this is part of the PSR0 compatibility, and I promise I will explain what this is for soon. And then if we open this up, we're going to create one more folder called controller. Now at this level of the directory structure, there will end up usually being several different directories that split up the code in a pretty meaningful way, so the folders in this directory will generally make sense. You're just going to be wondering why these directories aren't three directories up. Okay, now let's step back up the directory structure back to our glue module folder and expand this so you can see what it looks like. So we have lib, Drupal, glue, and controller. And now what we're going to do is get our page functioning, and then we'll come back and talk about the implications. This is actually going to be a point that we jump off from in order to explore various ideas and techniques that Drupal 8 is using. Now, within this controller folder, if we open it up, we're going to create a new file called gluecontroller.php. Now, this could actually be named anything we wanted, but the convention is to end it with controller and to start it with something that's descriptive. Our module is simple enough that just using the name of the module is descriptive enough. So let's open this up in an editor, and then we'll step back up the directory tree back to our module folder, and let's open up in the steps folder the fifth step called gluecontroller.php hello world page method. And we're going to copy this entire code and paste it in our gluecontroller.php file and save it. Okay, so like I said before, we're going to come back and talk about this code in just a little bit. But the next thing that we need to do in order to make this page function in Drupal is add some routing data. So let's go back to our file browser, and inside of our base glue directory, we're going to create a new file called glue.routing.yml or YAML. Okay, here's our file. Let's open this up in our editor. It's empty for now. And let's open up the sixth step, which is glue.routing.yml, add our first route. And we'll copy all of this code and we'll paste it into our glue.routing.yml file and save it. So this is the second file that we've run into so far that uses the YAML syntax. And you can see it's a little bit different in structure. Again, we'll come back to this in a moment. But already using the YAML syntax is paying off. We have two different files that do two totally different things that are able to use the same structure and the same tools in order to parse the data out of them. Okay, so this is enough to get our page to be viewable, but it's not really complete for our site. We need some additional data around this page. So we need to add that via a hook menu item. So go back to the step files and open up the seventh step, which is called glue.module hook menu to register link. And then let's also open our .module file if you don't have it open, so glue.module. And we're going to copy all of the code that's in the seventh step file and we're going to paste it in our glue.module file over the code that's already there, and we're going to save it. So you can see the only addition here is this glue menu, this hook menu function, and we have a bit of data here. Okay, so before we go into discussing the code, let's make sure it works. So we'll go back to our browser, and we're going to go to the performance page and clear all of our caches one more time in order to register this new page item. Just like in Drupal 7, we have to clear our caches when we add additional menu items through our module. Okay, now let's go back to our home page and define the path to the page that we just added. We would go to our routing file, so glue.routing.yml, and here for the pattern, it's hello world, and this is the pattern that we need to copy to paste into the address bar. So I'll copy that, jump back to the browser, and paste it in, and hit enter. And here we have our hello world page. So you see it says hello world here. Our hello content is being provided by our hook page alter, but we have successfully registered a page with Drupal. Now right now the title says home, and this mostly has to do with a bug in Drupal 8 that will be resolved before it's released.